Hello. Do you know one thumb rule of effective learning? If students don't enjoy learning, then put them in such an environment where they will enjoy life and they will not even realize that they have learned something. One more question. How many of you don't like to play? A very difficult question to answer, because we all know that children as well as adults love playing. If we use games, play environment for educational purpose, don't you think learning will be more effective? Let's see. For that, we will need to learn game mode of computer assisted instruction. So today we are going to discuss about game mode of CAI, that is game mode of computer assisted instructional environment. Let's see what we are going to learn today. Today we are going to see what we mean by game mode, what are various definitions, what are characteristics of game mode, what is basic structure of a game, what are different types of game mode, and what are factors which are essential in any game. Let's also discuss advantages and limitations of game mode. Let's proceed. So the objectives of this session are: define the term game, explain basic structure of an instructional game with the help of examples, illustrate major factors of a game, describe characteristics of a game, and discuss advantages and limitations of game mode. Let's see this definition. A game is a structured or semi-structured activity usually undertaken for fun, and it's sometimes also used as an educational tool. Graldler defines game mode as any contest, that is play, among adversaries, that is among players, operating under constraints for an objective. Now, these constraints may be various rules defined for that play, and the objective is winning the game, achieving victory, or playoff. So instructional games can be defined as games because they apply a permanent set of rules and a way of winning. They attack the area of basic skills, but also give conditions in which problem solving skills are used for winning. So when the learner tries for winning, tries to follow all rules and still try to achieve victory, in that process of winning, in that process of playing, learner goes on achieving basic skills. Also, learner can be put in a problem-solving situation where many problem-solving skills can be achieved. For example, learner also uses logical thinking. Learner may think creatively about new ways of achieving victory. And this environment, in turn, helps the learner achieve those skills. Let's see this game. In this game, penguin needs to cross various steps so as to win the race. There are three different players who are actually computer players along with this penguin. Now there is one problem, 5 into 1. So the penguin needs to jump on the number 5 plate. You can see number 5 plate. So if you click on that, penguin will jump there and there will be another multiplication problem. Now suppose the learner is Sonal. So she is typing her name and let's say continue. Play now. You can see that there are some imaginary learners. And along with these learners, see, these learners have started playing also. So let's quickly start playing, otherwise we will be lagging behind. So if we are delayed in jumping, then others are going to jump. two simultaneous learners are playing, Sonal and somebody else. Again, do you want to see? See, this is another learner who is also jumping with us. So we have to keep in front, otherwise if we delay, then the other learner is going to, other partner, imaginary competent opponent is going to go ahead. So the partner is going and we are competing. We are still ahead. What if we do mistake? Oops. So we are not the winner. We are on second number. So Sonal is on second rank. Let's see the result now. See, we are on the second rank. Now let's play again. Here the learner gets to see that I am not topping. So again Sonal will start the game with other partners. Now let's be quick and let's try to win. Two ones are two. 3 into 5, 15, 6 into 5, 30, then 3 ones are 3, then 36, 45, 56, 11 ones are 11, 4 tens are 40, 35, we are quick, we are fast, and now there is nobody ahead of us. Forty-four, sixty, eighty-eight, one thirty-two, sixty, ninety-nine, ninety-six, and finish. Wow, now Sonal is the winner because of us. So this is how Sonal has played this game. And she has won also. In the result, she will be on the first rank. And all other partners are behind. See, this is the second ranker. So Sonal stands first. Great, we end the game here. From this penguins game, can you identify essential characteristics of game? Let's see. What are characteristics of any game mode? For any game, objectives are predefined. Learner exactly knows where to reach. For example, in this particular game, the learner is told that the learner has to establish his or her own family in a goodie city. Now, what is that goodie city and how to establish that? The learner will play and do that. So objectives are defined in any game. Whenever you play any game, you start with rules. Remember badminton, tennis, remember chess, remember any playing cards game. Rules are well defined. Here in this game also, the character is explaining game's rules. So, whenever you develop any educational game, first decide rules of that game. Only rules won't help. There should be reward also. Remember this penguin game? There is always finish and then there are rank. So, if you jump to the finish first, then you are the winner. Here, all ranks are demonstrated. So, the learner, Joy, can be on the first rank. So that is reward for the learner. Any game should be replayable. Imagine if you don't win, and if you don't even get chance to replay the game, then there will be demotivation. We do not want any learner to be demotivated, and that's why always provide play again facility to the learner. The learner has to play games, and that's why learner should be given maximum possible controls. Whenever there are many controls and many variables to play with, the game can be a simulation kind of game. Now see this game. The learner can actually increase speed of the character and many other variables. Can you see those blue continuums? Learner can move those and change variables so as to play the game. When we design game, we need to understand basic structure of a game. So, there is introductory section where rules can be defined, rewards can be told, goal can be defined. After learner goes through everything, then the game is presented. Once the game is presented, learner's action is required. So learner acts and sometimes opponent reacts. Now this opponent can be an object or opponent can be other players also. Those can be human learners or computer can play against the learner. So the entire game system gets on updated as per learner's actions. For example, in Goody City, the learner goes on building a city. So the entire city gets updated and the learner can see the city designed, developed, updated by himself or herself. Whenever the goals are achieved, then there is reward. So that's closing. Here either you can summarize what the learner has done. For example, rate of learner, accuracy of learner, rewards won by the learner. Entire summary can be presented and then replay facility can be given. So, even along with the game system updates, new levels can be presented, new actions can be required, then learner goes on playing level 1, level 2, level 3 and the system goes on getting updated before the actual closure. This is the basic structure of any instructional game. So we have seen what is an educational game, what are essential characteristics of a game, and what is basic structure of a game. Do you think you will be able to identify which particular computer assisted instructional package is game mode, which is tutorial, or which is something different than game? Happy learning. Thank you.